for my house, and I'm going to do a secret appearance. People have no idea, so I'm hoping to give them a surprise. It's nice, it's really so silly. I'm a little bit of a hoarder. I'm very sentimental about the things that have come my way, and I think it maybe comes from coming from a background where I didn't have much, so I really cherished anything, a gift that somebody gave me, or something that just, I don't know, something I just couldn't part with.
The House of Annie Lennox in the Theatre and Performance Galleries at the V&A is a very intimate installation based around the concept of a house that focuses on creativity and inspiration at the very heart of it. We have worked with Annie for the past 18 months creating something that I think feels really special, and I hope she does too.
We've worked collaboratively to create a little installation that is very intimate and really is a collation of some of the things in my archive. It's not everything that I have, it's just a slice.
The challenge, I suppose, was in quite a small area, giving a snapshot of her career across politics and the awards she's won and her humanitarian at work, and her as a creator, really. I think that's what we really wanted to focus on.
There was a tremendous amount of work went into the last few decades of my life. Creative work in all facets, whether it came down to graphic design, costume design, lighting, scripting for videos, composing music, lyrics, arrangements, creating characters and stories, that it's been, looking back, an incredibly productive creative life. Today, I'm just sitting in my house in the exhibition, and I'm being asked some questions on Twitter. Who would be your ideal dinner guest? Your guest can be living or dead. I don't have a dead guest. What's intrigued me for so many years has been about that ambiguity, that, you know, when are you you? Performance, are you less real in performance or are you more real in performance? Are you being more authentic? When I look at the picture of myself, I go, wow, did I really wear my hair like that? You know, the changes of your life. When were you more authentically yourself? And I don't know if we're not, any of us are ever, you know, solid in that respect.
I walked through once and I definitely thought there was sort of a model or someone either pretending to be her or she was actually made of plastic. She was kind of lying back.
Automatically made me think of Alice in Wonderland.
Let's look around. Oh, it's a little house. It's all her costumes. Wow!
I think she encompasses a lot more than just music, so it's good to sort of break down those barriers with an exhibition like this.
Like a time travel machine.
It was the best of all to see her there, real life.
Here we do have Annie here at the window. You see, welcoming us.
At her house?
At her house.
And then Anna said, oh, it's actually her. And I was like, what?
Pretty unexpected.
Had to drag her back in again.
Looking in through the window.
This is a lovely sort of junction, you know, I'm at a juncture now, because in collating it all and putting it into an exhibition or an installation, I think I am coming to a point where I'm going, this is what we did, Eurythmics did, this is what I've done. And it's kind of like a very elegant pause for reflection.